talk about gastric secretion disorders, gastritis. A general view of the stomach. It is divided into the upper part called body or fundus and the lower part called antrum, which communicates with the duodenum through the pylorus. The stomach has four layers: serous, muscular, formed by three other layers, the submucosa and the mucosa, which is in contact with food. Now, let's focus on gastritis, which is defined as the inflammation or swelling of the stomach's mucosa. There are several types, including acute gastritis and chronic gastritis. Acute gastritis, which is caused by Helicobacter pylori, and within it, we find erosive or hemorrhagic gastritis, where we find several superficial erosions in the stomach mucosa. Between the risk factors, we find bacterial endotoxins or ingesting irritant substances such as NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, acetyl salicylic acid, alcohol, corrosive agents, trauma, burns, and stress. If we suffer it, we would feel nauseous, have pyrosis, gastric pain, or discomfort, and anorexia. If it complicates, it can lead to ematemesis, which is blood in vomit, myelina, which is blood in feces,
and a common test is searching for fecal occult blood.
While the prevalence of chronic gastritis has decreased in the developing countries in the recent years, acute gastritis is still very common. Chronic gastritis, it is produced by the same microorganism. When inflammation occurs, your stomach lining changes and loses some of its protective cells. The chronic swelling of the stomach is often asymptomatic, but when associated to other disorders, we can find peptic ulcer or gastric neoplasia due to Helicobacter pylori and pernicious anemia in atrophic gastritis. There are two types of chronic gastritis, type A or atrophic, which occurs in the gastric body. It is an autoimmune mechanism in which antibodies are created against the parietal cells of the stomach, which secretes hydrochloric acid, an intrinsic factor. Therefore, no hydrochloric acid is produced, and because there is no intrinsic factor, vitamin B12 is not absorbed and pernicious anemia occurs. It can give a precancerous lesion called intestinal metaplasia as the cells disappear. Type B or non-trophic, it will occur in the antrum and really is an inflammation of the mucosa of the stomach with predominance of lymphocytes. Symptoms are mainly feeling nauseous, vomiting, and gastric pain.